Dear friends, we are in Human Resource Management, BBA, second year, third semester subject, and we are in the second unit. In the previous class, we have learnt about human resource planning. What are the components, what is the process, what is the importance, everything regarding human resource planning we have learnt. And in our previous lesson, in our previous class, we have started discussing job analysis. What is a job analysis? Just I will recap. See, job means a group of homogeneous tasks, means similar tasks we are going to find in a job. And a job consists of duties, responsibilities, and tasks which are related to a common goal. Okay, it is defined and specific and can be accomplished, quantified, measured, and rated. Performance on the job can be measured, can be quantified, and can be rated in comparison with another person. In comparison with same person's previous performance, present best performance can be compared. Let us take for example, if you are a student, means your job is to learn. In unit test 1, whatever marks that you got can be compared with that of unit test second marks. First unit test marks can be compared with your performance with that of second unit test. So similarly, any job that is assigned to individuals can be measured, can be rated, can be compared. Now analysis, as you know, is related to detailed study or examination of something. Now coming to job analysis, it is a combination of these two words, job and analysis. In a job, similar tasks will be there, similar duties will be there, similar responsibilities will be there, and you are going to study, you are going to conduct a detailed study or examination as to what to be performed. So that is what you mean by saying job analysis. It is a detailed study of the job that has to be performed, that job that has to be understood. Okay, so job analysis, these are the things that are related to job analysis. Job analysis relates to tasks that make up a job, conditions under which an employee performs his job, and what exactly a job requires in terms of aptitudes, attitudes, knowledge, skills, educational qualifications, and the physical working condition of the employee. All this you are going to analyze in job analysis. So various definitions related to job analysis we have discussed in our previous class. So these are the definitions of famous persons. Okay, now job analysis is related to what we have to perform, what are the tasks, when they have to be performed, where they have to be performed, how they have to be performed, any deadline is there, what are the conditions, what are the equipments, tools that will be given to the employee to perform certain tasks, certain job, everything will be discussed in job analysis. Now coming to benefits of job analysis, what are the benefits of job analysis? See, it provides us with first hand job related data. Okay, whatever entire data relating to a job will be available if job analysis is done. So risks can be identified in a better way. See, whatever risks are there, that risks can be identified in a better way with relation to job analysis. If job analysis is done, risks can be identified clearly. Okay, now identification of the skills and abilities. What are the skills required to perform a particular task? What are the abilities that are required? Suppose an organization is trying to recruit a person who fits in a particular job. So before going for an interview or written test, they have to identify the skills. What skills are required to perform a particular job? What are the abilities that are required for a particular job? Everything will be discussed. So identification of competencies. What are the competencies? What are the efficiencies required to perform a particular job can be identified if we perform job analysis. And improvised decision making. So that is what I have told in the previous point. improvised decision making during recruitment and hiring process. So during recruitment, what is the criteria, what is the minimum qualification, what is the minimum technical knowledge, what is the minimum skill required for a person to perform a particular job, and in case of hiring, much help. Okay, now so these are the some of the benefits, and so improvised decision making during the recruitment and hiring process is possible with the help of job analysis, and better replacement decisions can be taken if job analysis is done. Replacement means in organizations it happens that a person retires, a person gets transferred, a person gets promotion, a person gets demotion, a person sometimes gets suspended, a person sometimes gets dismissed from the service, from the job. So in that case we have to find a person who fits into his place. That is what you mean by saying a replacement. So for better replacement decisions, job analysis will be of much help, and specific and accurate job descriptions will be done. Job description means it describes job, what are the qualities, what are the qualifications required. In writing it will be there, job description. It is possible only with the help of job analysis. If job analysis is done properly, proper job description will be available. Okay, accurate job postings will be available. Job postings means, see, whenever recruitment takes place, after the recruitment process is over, you have to post that person in a particular job, and that is possible only when you conduct job analysis in a proper way. And relative importance of job to other jobs. See, in organization various jobs will be there. One will be purchaser, one will be seller, one will be cashier, one will be looking after advertising requirements, one will be looking after accounting requirements of the job. So every job in an organization is equally important. And if you want to compare, if you want to compare one's job's importance in relation to another job in the same organization or with that of the other organization, you have to perform job analysis. So performance appraisal means you will have to evaluate the performance of employees involved in a job periodically, after 1 month or daily, after 1 year we have to get their report how they have performed. So that is possible with the job analysis. If job analysis is not done, you cannot appraise the situation, you cannot appraise the performance of an individual. More equitable compensation plan. Compensation means for any services rendered by a person, you have to provide something. It is termed as salary, it is termed as wages, it is termed as perquisites. Any perquisite, in our previous classes I have mentioned, perquisites implies providing a house, rent free accommodation, or providing gas cylinder, providing free electricity, providing free education, providing free medical facility to individuals like that. So that is possible only when you analyze the job conditions under which an individual is performing. You have to check properly, and that is possible only when you conduct job analysis. And training requirements will be performed, your organization will be able to provide proper training to individuals only when you analyze the job properly. So these are some of the advantages of job analysis. So these are the uses of job analysis. You can see the job analysis leads to two things: job description and job specification. And these are very, very important in an organization. Please remember, job analysis leads to job description and job specification. Job description, as I have mentioned already, job description, you are going to give in writing. These are the qualifications. These are the tools that are required in a particular job. In order to perform those tasks, what are the qualifications required? What are the tools? What are the equipments required? That will be mentioned in writing in a job description. Coming to job specification. See, this is also an output of job analysis. Job specifically you are going to mention. See, job description in writing you are going to give, whereas job specification will be a detailed note of the tasks that are going to be performed, minimum qualification or output or whatever it may be relating to a job. Everything specifically means to the point, accurately you are going to say, you are going to mention in job specification. Job description implies in writing you are going to say job specification specifically to the point accurately. You will be able to tell what are the things that are related to a job that you can clearly mention with the help of job specification. So these two are part and parcel of job analysis. With the help of job analysis, you can specifically give in writing, that is job description. You can specify, you can mention what are the things that are there, that are incorporated in a job. This is possible only when you do job analysis. Now, whatever I explained in a diagram, it is there, you can see. Organizational design is possible with the help of job analysis. See, with the help of job analysis, these two are the output of job analysis. You will be able to describe the job totally and you will be able to specify the requirements, everything related to a job with the help of job analysis. See, ultimately it leads to organizational design. Organizational design implies what are the roles of various jobs in the organization. What are the roles that are going to be performed by various employees that are working in various jobs in the organization. Organization and manpower planning, it helps in job analysis, helps in organization and manpower planning. Placement and orientation, you can train them, you can place them properly. You can recruit them, you can select them properly if job analysis is done properly. You can provide them training, you can provide them developmental activities. I mentioned the difference between training and development. Training is generally given to lower level employees. Developmental training is generally given to a higher level employee, that is manager or managing director or any other person. So safety and health. See, if job analysis is done, you will come out with what are the conditions in which an employee has to perform his job. So you can come up with safety measures. Suppose if you take cricket match, if a batsman comes, he comes with gloves, he comes with pads, he comes with guard, he comes with helmet. How? Because he knows his job, he has done his job analysis. What has to be performed, he clearly knows whether to face a pace bowler, speed bowler, or a spin bowler, he estimates correctly. And he comes up with a helmet, that is a safety measure. Similarly, if an employee's job involves in going undermine, he has to perform a mining job. Let us take, for example, Singareni coal mines. So he will go with helmets, that is going to have lights. And other safety measures can be taken if you perform job analysis. And employee counseling is possible. Counseling means a mental help in case of any problem in a particular job. Okay. So performance appraisal can be done. Performance appraisal means you can check whether whatever job requirements are there, whatever job output that you defined to an employee, in a particular day you have to produce 100 units, you have to produce 50 units, that you clearly mentioned in advance. But whether the employee has performed the task or not, you will not know until and unless you can compare, and that comparison is possible with the help of job analysis. So these are the advantages, these are the uses of job analysis. Okay. I hope you understood what job analysis means, what are the uses of job analysis. I hope you understood very well. So thank you very much, dear friends. In next class, we will meet again.